Good afternoon, guys. Today we're going to go over some mobility progressions for the squat. Now, we're not talking about assessment, we're not talking about squat technique, we're just talking about some basic drills to open things up, to allow you to access a given range of motion, and then hopefully start to drill the squat. Now, doing all these drills do not guarantee that you can squat well. Okay? You obviously have to have the ability to move in various ranges of motion. Even if you move well, and let's say your hips move well and your ankles move well, good extension of your upper back, that doesn't guarantee that you're going to be able to squat well and efficiently. So mobility is just a piece of the puzzle. There's also motor control, which is basically the ability to control a specific range of motion. So basically, think of it this way. Once you've opened up a given range of motion, now you need to control it. So that's actually stability and or motor control. And then lastly, technique. You can have great mobility, you can have great or adequate motor control, but your technique could stink. So there's several layers, so that's something to think about. We're gonna start very, very simple. We're gonna start with the ankles. I'm gonna give you a couple drills for the ankles. Then we're gonna address the hips, and then lastly, the upper back. Now this is one of my favorite progressions. Use what works for you. If something causes pain, avoid it, okay? So the first thing we're gonna do is just some basic ankle mobility, specifically ankle dorsiflexion. The biggest mistake people make on this is they try to move the ankle with a pronated foot, or they're just performing these kind of lackadaisically, right? Because maybe they don't feel a big stretch. That's fine, but when we are doing our ankle mobility, we need the presence of an arch here, okay? And we wanna make sure that we're aiming the knee over the kind of the fourth and fifth toe. Now the mistake people make is they just do their ankle glides, right? And the heel pops off the ground. So you see a lot of this. That's not what we're looking for. What we're looking for here is, again, we want a nice arch in the foot, and we want to glide the knee over the pinky toe and then come back. Over the pinky toe and come back. Now sometimes these big sweeps work really well. Other times you want to get to the end of that range of motion where you feel like you've got a little restriction and just do some basic sort of bumps at that end range. And that seems to clean it up pretty well. That's to focus on the interior ankle. Now, if you're looking to kind of open up the backside, some basic calf stretching will work. A lot of the times doing some soft tissue work, some foam rolling on the calves is a great way to do that. So ankle glides is a huge, huge part of it. And I'm gonna show you my favorite mobility sequence, okay? So we're gonna get into rocking position and in the quadruped position on all fours, and we're just gonna start with some basic rocks, okay? When you're doing this, you wanna feel like you're not catching in your hips, right? You wanna make sure that when you're rocking, it's just very, very comfortable. So we're gonna start with some basic rocks, okay? About hip width, and we're just gonna rock back and forth and go from there. What I like to focus on is a big chest and a neutral head. From there, we're gonna take that same idea of rocking and we're gonna go into an adductor rock. Everybody uses these. You can find a bazillion blogs doing adductor rocks, but they do work well. So I like this whole sequence though. If you're looking to move the adductors, feet straight, okay? That's very, very important to understand. If you are looking to lengthen the hamstrings, you're gonna go this positioning. All right, so what I like to do is some basic rocks. Okay, nice and steady. Do a dozen of those. From there, I actually like to sit back and perform some external rotations. You'll notice I'm square. What I like to do is I'll kind of rotate and open up and lean. Rotate and open up. And again, a dozen of those. And then lastly, you're gonna just focus on some basic toe pumps. This is a big old stretch in the hamstring, okay? So pay attention to that. We're gonna hit both sides. From there, I like to go right into work with a kettlebell, okay? I found that this is the fastest way to get people to open up. We're not just doing a light goblet squat. There is a method to the madness. Now, the beauty of the goblet squat is you can use the kettlebell away from you to act as a counterbalance. So we're just gonna be here, push the kettlebell away. Now, first thing we're gonna do is keeping the heels down, show you, just gonna wiggle, okay? So when we wiggle, You're going to go into a little bit of internal hip rotation and tiny, tiny bit of external hip rotation. Okay? We're going to wiggle just side to side. Now from there, what I'm going to work on is kind of collapsing my rib cage.
Extending.
Collapsing.
And then extending.
And then from there, what I'm going to do is I'm actually really going to focus on driving the knees outward. So I'm going to drive the knees outward. It's going to be a big stretch. And once I get some tension on the adductors, I'm going to actively push against my elbows. And then relax. And then shake it out. And it's the same thing. I'm going to actively push. And after you push, kind of relax. So we're just going to wiggle side to side. We're going to shake it out. Going to pry those hips. And make sure that, again, we're using the kettlebell to allow us to get a little bit deeper via counterbalance. I'll usually spend about 30 seconds at the bottom and then jump back down. Now, some other things you can do with the bottom position. You can curl. Some people like to do some curls, which work really well. Some people like to do some press outs. Some press outs work well also. So it's just, again, another drill to help you focus on prying the hips, getting a nice deep positioning. Okay, this little sequence right here will get you a lot of mileage, okay? Some of you may need a little bit more, that's fine. After you kind of work on those hips, guys, the last thing we need to focus on is extension of the thoracic spine. That's one thing that people forget about. A lot of times they collapse. And listen, if you're gonna put a bar on your back, you need to be able to extend that thoracic spine. So one of the things that I like to focus on is this really simple wall drill, which is gonna allow you to open up the T-spine, but also allow you to get a posterior weight shift to open the hammies up, and it's gonna allow to work on shoulder flexion, but the setup's key. So we face the wall, hands are up front, we pull the ribs down, okay? Once we pull the ribs down, we walk back, and we're gonna weight shift into this position. And then from here, we're just gonna breathe. As we exhale, what I want you to envision is someone took a kettlebell and put it right in your mid back. And as you exhale, that kettlebell is just gonna push that chest down and through. Okay, think about every breath, we've added a couple pounds to that kettlebell, right? It just got a little bit heavier, a little bit heavier. So we get more and more extension through the thoracic spine. And then go from there. Some other fantastic drills to open up the T-spine. You can do some sideline rib pulls. You can do some quadruped positions, like a lumbar lock, etc. But the key on squatting well is to open up the ankles to address the hips. And then lastly, obviously, the thoracic spine. Now, if those do the trick for you, again, like I said, there's still motor control to consider and there's still squat technique. So little simple drills that you can do. This whole progression maybe takes 8 to 10 minutes. If your hips are gunked up or your ankles are gunked up, you're probably going to need a little bit more work, but simple strategies to improve your squat.